Rosetta had been at Comet 67P Churyumov-Gerasimenko for over 650 days and had seen many incredible things. She had mapped the entire surface of the nucleus and spotted dramatic changes over time. Rosetta followed the comet as it got ever closer to the sun and saw more and more gas and dust streaming from its surface. At that time, Rosetta had to keep at a safe distance because the comet was so active and the environment was very dusty. Rosetta knew that astronomers back on Earth were also observing the comet, and she enjoyed seeing the images of how it looked from afar. It made her realize just how vast the comet's tail was, over 10 million kilometers. She explored some of the tail herself on excursions that took her over 1,000 kilometers from the nucleus. There, she studied how the stream of charged particles flowing from the sun affects the comet. Even though Rosetta was far away, she often thought of Philae, who she had not heard from since before their closest approach to the sun. She hoped that he had also enjoyed the view on the comet when it was most active. Later, as they moved back towards the outer solar system, the comet became less active and it was finally safe for Rosetta to get closer again. Whenever she flew over Philae's home, she listened out for any signals from him. She wanted to tell him about the amazing discoveries that the scientists back home had made using the data he had collected down on the comet. They had found the surface to be much harder than expected, and that the comet contained many ingredients, including some complex molecules that could be the building blocks of life as we know it on Earth. Even though Rosetta could not see or hear Philae, she tried to make contact with him just in case he was listening. But unfortunately, they could not seem to get connected. Perhaps Philae had fallen back into a deep sleep, or maybe his radio was broken, but she was still very proud of him. After all, he had accomplished so many of his important tasks on the comet, and he was understandably tired. Rosetta, too, had made many exciting discoveries in the last year. She found patches of water ice on the surface of the comet, and witnessed how the ice, heated by sunlight during the day, turned into gas and escaped into space, while new ice formed again every night. Besides water, Rosetta found many other molecules as she studied the atmosphere of the comet, including lots of oxygen. Scientists were very surprised to find so much. They thought that most of the oxygen would have reacted with other atoms. But perhaps it had been locked into the ice when the comet formed 4.6 billion years ago. The scientists were excited by what this discovery could tell them about the history of the solar system. By looking carefully at pictures taken by Rosetta, they also figured out how the comet got its curious shape. It likely happened when two smaller comets slowly crashed into each other billions of years ago. The scientists had also long wondered how the comet looks like from the inside. To find out, they studied the radio beams that Rosetta and Philae had sent to one another through the comet. They also measured how the signals that Rosetta sent back to Earth changed as the comet's gravity gently tugged on her while she flew around it. These experiments showed that the comet had no caverns under the surface larger than 100 meters. In fact, it was made up of a mix of loosely packed dust and ice grains on the inside. The comet was fluffy under its hard crust. Rosetta was thrilled of having made such great discoveries. But there was still a lot of work to be done. Rosetta only had a few more months left to make the most of her extraordinary mission before the grand finale. Far from the energy of the sun, Rosetta too would come to rest on the surface of the comet. But that's another story.